I've got a horse. I've got a horse. I've got a horse to beat the favorite. God make the bees. The bees make the honey. The soldier did the dirty work. The bookie takes the money. Why do the bookie take the money? Because you back favorites. Do you need any brains backing horses? It's the game. The game. It grips you. It makes you, thrills you. All you want is a pin, a fork. And if you can back them, the black man stands before you, dressed like a prize rabbit, sent here by Parliament to do work of national importance. I'll close the labor exchange. I'll stop the means test. I'll give you what the Englishmen want. It's roast beef, two veg, Yorkshire pudding, beer flow through your ears, whiskey and soda, the best wine from France, and I'll give you a wife. And when you get your wife, boys, no lodger, put the light out. And remember, gentlemen, the luck is wonderful. The great King Edward said, my horse, a horse, my...
Ras Prince Manalulu was the most famous black man in Britain between the wars. He was a national icon renowned for his eccentricity, a racing tipster of such theatricality that even in the days when newspapers carried few photographs and television was in its intimacy, he was still the most recognizable racing personality other than the top jockeys. As a horse racing tipster came into regular contact at the racetracks and elsewhere with princesses and lords, the rich and the famous, and in general, the landed gentry. After all, the business of racing thoroughbred horses was the sport of kings. On the 2nd of November 1936, Ras Prince Manalulu achieved a slice of immortality. In that year, the BBC began its television service, and Ras Prince Manalulu was the first black person to appear on screen on that very first day of British television broadcasting.
Now you can go home and have the good things of life. And remember, we have robbed him. We shall come back again. So goodbye, boys.
Goodbye.
What I told you, tomorrow's another day. But remember, I've got a horse. I've got a horse.
I've got a horse.
I've got a horse.
I'll show you exactly where he used to stand. Here. Prince Manalulu stood here. This is his pitch. This was his pitch for years. I got a horse.
Ras Prince Manalulu from Ethiopia.
That goes back many, many years. Even I was younger.
Do you remember any impressions of him that you can remember?
No, not really. I was quite a lot younger than I am now. No, I don't really remember any at all, to be quite. I just remember him going through, I got a horse, you know.
Prince Manalulu, when I was a little girl, he used to come through. Actually, I came when I was really small, because I'm not that old, honestly. I come with my dad, and he used to scare me. My dad said, never be scared, that's Prince Manalulu. I got a horse! Come and have £3, look around. Yeah, he was well known. He was like an icon, a legend down here. Prince Manalulu. Thank you very much, darling. Have a nice day. Yeah. They were the good old days. Just tall, the great big, you know, you got to remember in them days, like, a black man was rare, you know, and to see an elaborate, you know, he was a showman, he was lovely.
Do you
remember a black man called Ras Prince Manalulu?
I remember him. Oh, of course. Well, you're going back about 50 years.
Well, point. That's my point.
Yeah.
Do you have any tales? Do you have any memories of this man?
Oh, yeah. So happened.
he used to walk through the market here. And we used to have quite a lot of chat with him. He was so good. Always shouting. And he was such a nice man.
So that sounds like he came from Evian. He used to tip horses. He used to go out the race and he used to charge people his shilling for a horse. So if he had six horses in a race, right, he gave them all one each. Somebody had a win. So they sent him some money as a thank you. Prince Monolulu, that's him.
That's what he looked like.
That's him, yeah. That's the geezer.
He's having a story.
Prince Monolulu.
Right. Do you have any stories?
Prince Monolulu, he was always down in Goldson Street. He used to come down every Sunday.
I've got a horse.
Huge man with his feathers, colourful robes. That's him. Doing very well.
Do you remember what age you were?
Pardon?
Do you remember what age were you?
Me?
Yeah.
When I started here in 1948, I was 15. And I suppose for the next 20 years he must have been coming down here, I suppose. You know, I was in Goldson Street at the time, which is around the corner. And he was a character. There were a lot of characters there.
It's English.
He used to anywhere there was a crowd, he'd go, and at the Epsom Derby, he'd be there on that day, the Grand National. He had a horse. There could be 30 runners, and he'd give everybody a different horse. Somebody had to have
the winner,
and that person would come back.
And he was that popular, wasn't he?
Yeah.
He used to walk along here every Sunday in his uniform. In his got a horse, yeah. Rash Prince Monolulu, that's him. That's him, yeah. But he wasn't a prince.
Right. He wasn't a prince. Right.
He called himself prince.
We used to have a lot of characters like that in London.
But, I mean, it was survival, isn't it?
So we accepted them, they didn't do any harm.
Uh-huh. I had an uncle who was a tipster.
Yeah.
He used to call himself Felton the Jockey. And he was a character, he used to go to all the race meetings. I used to cover the Sporting Life, which was the racing paper. And he's come over here, I've got a horse today. I was up at 6 o'clock this morning watching the trials, and this horse is in the second race. And
it's all a load of rubbish.
Well, yeah. But they were characters.
Yeah, right.
They were characters that could hold a crowd.
And they did hold
a crowd. Yeah, they could hold a crowd, yeah.
People, they were like show business people, they got an audience.
Well, he got a bit into show business as well. Yeah. I mean, he had his picture taken with everybody and the whole thing.
Well, that was all good for
them. All the major horse race meetings, he was always there.
He was.
And he was known. And he was part of the act.
Was he really that tall?
Tall, he's a big fella.
He was.
And he wore the feathers. He was the stature of that guy there, about that build, something like that. Yeah.
I'll make you sing God Save the King, Rule Britannia, good old England, I've got a horse, I've got a horse.
I'm Prince Monolulu, from sunny Honolulu, from favorite Great Britain, I'm so lonely.
I'll show you exactly where he used to stand. Here.
Who?
Prince Monolulu stood here. This is his pitch. This was his pitch for years. I